Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Brothers Brawl. Last time, we did the second to last classic mode playthrough. I went the wrong way. Whoops, okay. I hit the A button before I moved over to the side. There we go. Last time, we did the second to last classic mode playthrough using Solid Snake himself from the Konami company. And this time, we're going to be using Mr. Cocky Hedgehog Guy Sonic the Hedgehog, who from, of course, Sega, the second and last third-party character in this game. So, starting off with his palette swaps, we have regular blue Sonic. He wears like little... Okay, Sonic doesn't really change color too much. He changes like his wrist wear. He changes tint, I guess, but yeah. So we got these black bangles, gold, light green, red, and back to normal. So as you can see, his color does change a little bit, but not too much. But of course, we are going to be going with regular Sonic, so let's go. Now, Sonic is another unlockable character, and believe it or not, he is the only character to have four methods of unlocking. I don't know why he has four, whereas everybody else in the game has three, but that is a thing, so the more you know. Now, of course, Sonic is fast. He's the fastest character in the game, because he's Sonic the Hedgehog. So, you're going to see a lot of me just running around and doing the dash attack, probably, but you know. Okay, so the methods for unlock, one of them is play 300 brawls and then defeat Sonic. Second one, complete classic mode with 10 characters, then complete Sonic. So in theory, he can actually be the first character you unlock. Fight for 10 hours on more, cumulative between multiple players in brawls, in the brawl mode, and then defeat Sonic. Or, of course, have him join you in Subspace. Now, the cumulative hours thing, that means the number of hours played times by the number of players that play them. So, say you do a hour-long match with four human players. That will count as 4 hours. So, you can literally just leave the game on with four people for 2.5 hours, and there's your 10 hours, because 2.5 hours times by four. So, there you go. That's that. Sonic special moves. Standard special move is homing attack. You can just press it once and he does a homing attack. Or I believe if you hit it faster, you like spam it, maybe it goes a little bit quicker. Maybe. I think maybe that's in the next game, but that's a thing you can do. And it can also be used to do what people call stall off stage, like this. Okay, not that, but on a stage such as Final Destination, you can get Sonic like stuck underneath the stage just by using the standard B, because he'll be trying to home in on the people up on the stage, and it will cause him to just kind of chill there. So it's pretty neat. And also he homing attacks onto the stage, I guess. The side special move is Spin Dash, which you may be thinking, why is Spin Dash not his down special move? I mean, that's how it's activated in the game, in the Sonic games. We'll get onto that. So Spin Dash, you just kind of goes, like so. You just press it, even if you start spamming the button, it doesn't make a difference. I believe if you press and hold, he does actually charge up the side special move, which we'll show off in a moment. But Sonic's a little weird. Okay, so yeah, you can charge it up like so, and then it like does a little jump before it sets off, etc., etc. And you can, I believe, you can jump out of it, and then you can like attack or whatever. I'm gonna try that again. Yeah, you can jump out of it. Okay, up special move is spring jump. He just jumps off of a spring, as you see there, and then if you use it on the ground, it actually stays put, and other people can use it. It's also one of those rare up special moves that lets you attack after using it. And then his down special move is known as Spin Charge, which is charged by spamming the B button. It doesn't jump at the beginning, and you don't jump out of it the same as you do with the side special move. You can jump out of it, sure, but you just jump up in the ball, as you see here. But if we use the side special move, whoops, I did that wrong. Let me try that again. Never mind, it's the same with the side special move. Hang on. Yeah, it's kind of the same. I don't know. Sonic's side and down special moves are very, very similar. I really don't know what the main difference is. I've never really been able to figure it out myself, but the more you know. And then his final smash is supersonic. He uses all 7 Chaos Emeralds, turns into supersonic, yells, "Now I'll show you!" And then runs around, flies around the stage, depending on the direction you push, and you can hit people and all that jazz. So that's that. We'll get onto his taunts in a moment here. His up smash, his down smash, his neutral air, his side and down Bs, and a few other moves probably, are all spin dash attacks. And the reason for that is actually, oh, here's supersonic. Now I'll show you, yeah! The reason for that actually, which may be introduced in the, or maybe mentioned in the trivia, is he was added like super late into the game, into the game's development. So they had to make most of Sonic's moves just where he goes into a ball, because they really didn't have all that much time. I believe they changed up a good portion of these moves in Smash 4, but for now, we gotta deal with Super Spin Dash guy. Okay, we'll get onto his taunts right here, assuming we get the chance. Assuming, why does Kirby look huge? They make his image huge to be next to DDD, but he just looks... He looks ridiculous. Imagine if Kirby was the size of DDD all the time. Okay, up taunt. He does a little forward flip, which is really cool because of his lanky legs, he can do that. Also, down throw as well is also a spin move, so that's a thing. I would like to show off the rest of his taunts. Oh, his neutral B as well. I didn't mention that when saying all of the spin moves, but his neutral B is also that. Boom! Oh, Meta Knight, you jumped! Okay, there we go. Double kill. Not bad. Okay. We got a lot of Sonic trivia that we'll get onto in a moment when I've done the rest of his taunts. All of the trivia doesn't fit on one page. Like, I can't fit it all on my screen, so that's a thing. Okay, side taunt when I can pull this off if Samus would leave us alone. Go away, Samus. Okay, side taunt. He does this, which is the classic, like, figure eight thing. Oh, God! We got pitfalled through the ground. And he says, "You're too slow!" Oh, his dash attack as well, that is also a spin dash, so he has a lot of spin dash moves. So Sonic's side taunt was changed in the next game. I believe he still does the running thing, but instead of saying, "You're too slow," he says, "Sonic Speed!" And it's... Why did they change that? Why wouldn't you keep it as, "You're too slow"? I much prefer that one. Okay. And then his down taunt, I believe he, like, spins... He does, like, a bit of break dancing. Let's see. Yep, and he goes, "Come on, step it up!" So there you go, that's Sonic the Hedgehog for you. He's a pretty neat character. He's a lot better in the next game, I think. Like, for example, when we did the 12-inch Pizza Fest tournament. Oh, did you die, Falco? No, of course you didn't, but maybe you can hit the bomb! There you go! When we did the 12-inch Pizza Fest tournament, Tale of the Toaster used Brawl's Sonic. Because he wanted to, like, learn him, I guess? I think that was the reasoning. Also, Falco, you suck. Okay. And then Toaster actually now mains Sonic in Brawl. I think he's one of his mains, anyway. And he says that Sonic's a lot... In Smash 4, sorry, not in Brawl. He says that he's a lot better in Smash 4, so there you go. Okay, we should get onto trivia, because like I said, it doesn't even all fit on my screen at one time. I'm gonna have to scroll down, so... Yup. And it's not even that, like, they have a lot of text in them. Some of them do, but most of these are just individual bits of trivia, so let's see how we do. Also, one of my favorite things to do with Sonic is run up, quickly turn around, and use a back air. Or not turn around, just run past them and use a back air, I guess. But if you just quickly turn around, like that, oh god. Okay, that was a forward air, but that works too. I'm gonna actually try this! Ugh. Okay, never mind. Wow, that rolling crate killed me. Okay, well now it's gonna kill you. Out you go, Bowser. And you, sir. There we go. Not bad. Okay, trivia. Along with Zero Suit Samus, Sheik, Squirtle, Jigglypuff, Toon Link, and Wolf, Sonic is one of the only characters to not be seen in trophy form during the Subspace Emissary due to his late appearance. He appears literally right before the final boss, so... Yep, if you haven't played Subspace, that's a spoiler for you, but Sonic is not a part of the main story, unlike Snake. I mean, he is, but not until the very end, whereas Snake plays a bit, much more important role in Subspace. Are you gonna die? Pit's dead, okay. Sonic, Link, Donkey Kong, Mega Man, Pac-Man, and Snake are the only characters to be playable in a fighting game. Also, it mentions Pac-Man because of the next game. And Mega Man. are the only characters playable in a fighting game other than in the Super Smash Bros. Series. Sonic appeared in Sonic the Fighters and Sonic Battle. Link appeared in the GameCube version of Soul Calibur 2. Donkey Kong appeared in the Wii version of Punch-Out. Mega Man appeared in the Marvel vs. Capcom series. Pac-Man appeared in Street Fighter X Tekken for some reason. And Snake appeared in Dream Mix TV World Fighters, which I believe is a Japanese exclusive game. I could be wrong there, but I've never heard of it before, and I looked it up before this episode, and yeah, I believe that is a thing. Okay, stop. Do that. Wait. Oh, I was listening to the music, and I thought it was playing, like, the Mission Impossible theme. Also, we just got slowed down there. Jeez, come on, Sonic. You missed. Oh, no. Don't give that to Snake. You're the fastest thing alive. He rolled past it. Okay. Hello, I'm Sonic the Hedgehog, and now I'm super friggin' big. Oh, something I didn't mention with Snake. I know this isn't an opportune time for it, but, I mean, he's here. With his grenades, you can actually, like, pick them back up after they've been thrown. That's not something I mentioned in the Snake run, but I figured since he's here and I just saw him throw a grenade, I may as well mention it. Okay, we're gonna break this Smash Ball right now. You're gonna get the friggin' Supersonic, and for some reason it didn't activate when I hit B. What? No. No, you don't, Snake. Oh my god, he's gonna grenade launcher us. We're probably gonna fail here. Oh, Sonic can also wall jump. That's a thing. Nope. No, you don't. We're the fastest thing alive. You're not gonna hit us today. This is not okay, well, you hit us once, but that's fine. Oh, wait, stop. There we go. Just try it, Snake. He's not even trying it. It's a Pokeball. Okay, Snake. Moltres, hello. Snake, go say hi to Moltres. Oh, don't, that's fine. Okay, more trivia. Between the second and third Brawl tier list updates, Sonic moved up 8 places from 31 to 23, making Sonic's tier placement tied with Olimar for the largest increase ever achieved in the Super Smash Bros. History. I guess people thought he was really bad when the game came out, and then he got a lot better. Same with Olimar. That's nice. That's actually really nice to know about... Bye, Ray Gun. Okay, about Olimar, because I really freaking like Olimar. I mean, not so much... Not as much as I used to, but I think he's... It's awesome that he's in the series, as I think I've mentioned previously. Okay. Get you out of the way. Come on. And then we can just... No. Spring up. Spring. There we go. There is a lot more frickin' trivia to go through, by the way. Okay. Sonic the Hedgehog was statistically the most anticipated character for Super Smash Bros. Brawl. Also, we're on stage 11 and I'm nowhere near through the trivia. Oh my god, this is gonna be ridiculous. I'm also gonna sneeze, so I apologize if that happens. At the video game convention E4All, Sonic was the only unlockable character to be playable in the Super Smash Bros. Brawl demo. I didn't know there was a demo of this game. I guess it was like a store type demo, but still. I did not know that that was a thing. Also, I'm pulling all sorts of weird faces right now to avoid sneezing, and this also is what I meant about stalling. You can just kind of chill off stage as long as there's someone on stage close to the edge, and you can actually just continue to use the homing attack like that. I don't know where it's useful, but I guess it's useful somewhere because it's in the game. No, I'd like to get back on stage, please. Luckily, with the homing attack, I can do that. Unfortunately, the homing attack is not quite that useful. Oh my god, no! Oh, wow. Oh, that was insane. I up-B'd out of the way of that. Oh my god. And also, can I just mention, of course, they would target me with that. Okay, friggin' DK, calm down. Get away! What are you, off-stage game right now? Stop, dude. Oh my god, he tried to get a dunk. Ooh! That was brutal. Okay. Right. Near the end of the Subspace Emissary, Sonic suddenly appears, seemingly from nowhere and with no explanation provided of how he got there. There are speculations claiming Sonic was put so late into the game due to his late was put so late in the game due to his installation in the game itself. That makes... Jeez, I swear, the people who write this trivia sometimes really don't know how to English good. What else we got? As far as the storyline might have went, it is speculated that at the time before the Great Invasion, when the Smashers attacked the Subspace gunship, for those of you who don't know what all this is, watch the Subspace Emissary LP that I did. Kick? Okay. The Subspace gunship's first shot covered an area. This is speculation. The Subspace gunship's first shot must have covered an area that Sonic was at, in subspace, and through subspace, Sonic traveled to Taboo's residence just before Taboo used his off-ways. Jeez, that is a long freaking bit of trivia. I know I said that not all of them were long, but that one's probably the longest. And we're just on stage 11, there's still a bunch of trivia to go. Okay, that gets rid of Lucario. No brutality for you today, Peach. I almost down-aired just then, that would have been really bad. Sticker, thank you. Okay. Sonic? Yeah! Oosh! Oh, I love his up air as well. That can be a pretty good move for setting up combos and stuff, I guess. Or ending combos, maybe? I'm not entirely sure, but it's a thing. I'm trying to utilize the side and down Bs into my move set, and it is not happening today. Dude, Peach, you gotta go! Thank you. Oh, heart container. I'll take that. Come on, Peach. Why are you taking forever to die? Ugh, there we go. Okay, even though Sonic is usually known for being unable to swim in his series, he is able to swim in Brawl. However, this is only for gameplay purposes. Sonic is the only unlockable character in Super Smash Bros. Brawl who has 4 unlock methods as opposed to 3. Sonic is capable of stalling by using the homing attack under a stage such as Battlefield and Final Destination. This, and the fact that it doesn't put him in a helpless state, makes for a good tactic in Multi-Man Brawl. That is true. I forgot to mention that part of that. Oh god, the next one is a bit on the spin dash. If Sonic uses his spin dash going upwards on a slope with a 45 degree angle or steeper, he will continue to spin dash horizontally even if there is no terrain for him to spin dash across. This technique can be seen on Pirate Ship when the ship is stuck on the island. The left pipe of Yoshi's Island, there's so much island, and the staircase of Temple and the bottom left leaf on Hanenbo. However, it's easiest to use on a custom stage. Okay, then it's a little odd. Sonic and Lucario, the only characters to wear their default costumes in team battles when they're on the blue team. I think I knew that. Oh god. Although, what about Squirtle? Oh no, the Pokemon trainer actually has a blue like palette swap, which is kind of weird. Kick you in the finger. I'm gonna break off your friggin' fingernails if you have any under there. Okay. Sonic's victory theme is the stage clear theme in Sonic 06, making it the only victory fanfare directly taken from another game. Super Smash Bros. Brawl is one of the few games that Sonic himself actually changes color, even though it's very slight, and if you're not counting like Super Sonic, because he's golden and he changes to him in a lot of games, then okay. This is the second time Sonic is seen using weapons, the first being Sonic and the Black Knight, despite the fact that in Shadow the Hedgehog, Sonic states he is against the use of weapons, though possibly only specifically to guns, by saying, personally, I wouldn't be caught dead using one of those things. Okay. And then the final bit of trivia, despite this being Sonic's first Smash Bros. Appearance, there were rumors about him being in Melee. I'm gonna slow this down. According to these rumors, Sonic, and sometimes Tails, depending on the source, were unlockable. Most sources claiming that this was after defeating 20 wireframes in Cruel Brawl. However, these rumors were proven false. Yeah, Sonic and Tails are definitely not in Melee. But there we go. With 18 coins, we've beaten Classic Mode with everyone. That is exciting. And of course, for the final Classic Mode playthrough, it's gotta be an image of Sonic versus Mario. This was the game that let you pit Sonic against Mario, and that is probably what had a lot of people hyped up, so yep. But with that, we have completed Classic Mode with every single character. So, let's go ahead and take a look at our Sonic trophy, the last Classic Mode trophy. And I guess in turn, we'll look at the Master Hand trophy while we're here, because he's been in every video. Sonic the Hedgehog, the world's fastest hedgehog who can run at supersonic speeds. Generally speaking, he loves being able to do what he wants and loathes being constrained. Holding still is something he would never consider. He's got a bit of an attitude, but can't pass by someone in trouble. When he collects the 7 Chaos Emeralds, he transforms into the mighty Golden Supersonic. I don't think I screwed up any word in that, which is awesome. And then he was in Sonic the Hedgehog 1991 on the Sega Genesis, I think. And of course they can't show that, and it's all in caps for some reason. And then on the Wii, Sonic and the Secret Rings. Okay, now where is our Master Hand trophy? He's around here somewhere. Master Hand? No, you in the Subspace Emissary series? There he is, okay. Master Hand. A being tied to the link between this world. The link between worlds? Oh! To this world where trophies fight and the world beyond. The meaning of his existence is unknown, as are his goals, but he seems to have obtained and kept hidden a power that borders on absolute. He also seems to feel a certain joy in challenging chosen warriors who've claimed many victories. He waits even now in Final Destination. And of course, N64 Super Smash Bros., GameCube Super Smash Bros. Melee, and Wii Super Smash Bros. Brawl, and of course, the upcoming Smash 4 as well. Well, it's not upcoming at this point, but upcoming at the point of this game. And I guess we'll also look at Crazy Hand. Even though we didn't get to fight him, he's a big part of classic mode if you play on harder difficulties, so yeah. Crazy Hand, seemingly a manifestation of the destructive spirit in direct contrast to Master Hand, who is the manifestation of the creative spirit. Crazy Hand appears out of nowhere when Master Hand's power begins to ebb, okay? His repeated attacks evoke the bizarre. Those who must face Master Hand and Crazy Hand at the same time face a long, painful battle to the death. And of course, Super Smash Bros. Melee on the GameCube, Brawl on the Wii, and Smash 4. So, I believe that is pretty much everything for all classic mode that we should look at in here. We've looked at every character's classic mode trophy. We've looked at Master and Crazy Hand. I guess the only other thing is Final Destination, if I can find that, because now I've said that, I kind of want to talk about it. Is it even a trophy in this game? Is it not? Wait, I thought there was a Final Destination trophy. I guess it's just Luigi's Mansion. Okay. Never mind me then. Others maybe? I doubt it. It would be in stage if anyway. Sure. Yeah, okay. That's interesting. Is there anything in here? No. Okay, there's no Final Destination trophy. I could have sworn there was, but I guess not. Unless it's like the one that I don't have, but I don't think it is. Anyway, let's go ahead and head back in here just because we can. That is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. Brawl. Of course, it's a little bit longer because we looked at more trophies. I also just want to ask for the final time, do you guys want All-Star Mode to be daily? One released every single day, because it will make the Brawl series go by a whole lot faster, and it will also mean that we can have an extra series in place of where Brawl originally was, because Brawl will be every day, so the time slot every 3 days for Brawl will be replaced with something else. So let me know, because of course All-Star is the next thing we'll be doing. Next time on Super Smash Bros. Brawl. I slurred my words. Okay, next time on Super Smash Bros. Brawl, we'll be starting All-Star Mode with, of course, my main man Mario, and we will be using different palette swaps, because we've used the regular ones for all the other stuff, so yeah. And as you see there, you can use two people. I will just be doing this solo, though. So, I would like to thank you all for watching this video. Make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed, and let me know what you thought of it in the comments section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.